How many times has that happened to you? Welcome to Sikbaggers YouTube channel. I'm Steve. Today I'm going to show you how to replace that big whip antenna that comes stock on your Harley Davidson touring models that have the radio in them and replace it with a shorter antenna, but not a stubby. We all know those little stubbies get crappy reception. I'm going to get you a better looking antenna on the back of this bike that actually still works. It's not going to be a big install video, guys. It is just an antenna, but these guys over at Ciro, they're always coming out with new stuff. And this one's pretty cool. Today we got the high caliber antenna from Ciro. It's approximately 12 inches long with a flexible base on the bottom. You can get this in black or chrome. Today we've got the black one to install on our customer's bike back here. This is a 2017 Street Glide, and it does, as you see in the beginning of the video, have that big long whip antenna on the back. Before I get into screwing this onto the bike and showing you the difference between the whip and this, I want to talk to you a little bit about this. I've watched a lot of YouTube videos, and I've been doing audio installs for quite a while now, and I've had a lot of guys come in here and request the little stubby antennas, and I try my best to talk them out of it, because here in Southern Illinois, it is pretty flat, but we do have some hills, and depending on where you're riding, those little stubby antennas are not going to pick up the radio stations that a normal antenna would, or even a 12 inch. Some of them opt out the antennas completely. The fender extensions from Advan Black that we sell don't have the holes for the antenna, but you know, I have cut some in and put the grommet back in and put an antenna back on. Said if you live in a really super flat area, those little 3 and 4 inches are going to do okay for you. They're not going to be optimal, but they're still going to work okay. But if you're just running the regular big long whip antenna back there and you want to save an eyeball and make your bike look a little bit cooler, this is an option that you can check out. Like I said, this is a brand new product from Ciro. It's not super hard to put on, but I just want to kind of go over the differences between a 12 inch, a long one that comes on the bike, and those little 3 and 4 inch stubbies. So this is designed for AM, FM, and weather band. The WB on the end stands for weather band. So if you want to hook this up to a weather band radio, you can do that as well. Like I said, this is for a customer. We're going to get it installed back here on this 2017 Street Glide, and then we'll show you what it looks like. So right here behind the fender extension on the rear strut mount right here, you've got a bolt that goes in right here that holds the antenna bracket. There's no need to take any of this stuff off. A lot of times, you can just simply twist this by hand and it'll break loose. If you can't get that antenna to break loose, go down here by the base with a pair of channel locks, just something small that you can get in there. Don't fudge up your paint. Once we get that pop loose, just simply unscrew the antenna and that's off. That, see, it's just a standard antenna. Instructions, like always, from Ciro. Like I said, this is the black one. You can get this in chrome. It does have a flexible rubber base, as you can see. Kind of got almost like a bullet end on it. Hopefully you guys can see that right there. I guess that's why they call it the high caliber, but pretty cool. So what we're gonna do is go back through this hole right here, go down, add a little bit of blue Loctite to the base, just like that. Put this one in. Tighten it. I'm going to take a towel and put it around the antenna and my channel locks really close to the base down here. And I'm just going to give it a twist just to make sure that it's good and tight on there. Now, with this size antenna, this would be the base of a tour pack bracket as well. So this size antenna probably not going to work with a tour pack, but with the rubber base like that, it could be bent out behind the tour pack, but it's still going to be resting up against the back of the tour pack and probably rubbing. If you do want to run this with a tour pack, I would relocate it with the extension that you can get from Harley Davidson. So we got it installed, but now let's check the reception. I am inside my shop, but that never really ever seems to make a difference. I'm gonna turn this down so we don't get copyright violations, but we're gonna check as soon as this thing gets booted up. This radio is kind of notorious for being pretty slow. So we'll turn it up a little bit just to show you that the stations are coming in. That one locked in, 99.9, 100.7, 101.5. These are all our normal local stations. 102.9 is local. 107.3 is our country station. So there's all the stations, guys. Won't you come on? Just letting them lock in long enough so you can see that they are working, but not get a copyright violation on my channel by playing music. So just want to show you that you got a sleeker, better looking antenna, and it still works great. So I'm throwing up a little before and after picture here so you guys can see it. And man, what a difference. You don't have that huge big whip antenna hanging out back there. So every time you walk around the back of the bike, you get stabbed in the beard or in the eyeball. Like I said, guys, super sleek antenna. You can get this in black or chrome. What an amazing difference between that short antenna that comes in just as good as the long antenna, but looks a lot better. You don't have to walk around the back of the bike and get stabbed in the eye every time you do. I walk through Harley Davidson and all these new bikes, and all I'm doing is just fending off antennas while I'm trying to walk back to the parts department. It's insane. One of the things I did want to touch on real quick, if you can't get that antenna off, sometimes these antennas are installed with a set screw. Maybe you've bought the bike used and somebody put a new antenna on it. It's got a set screw in it. Unless you loosen that set screw, that antenna is not coming off. Make sure you pop your saddlebag, get back in there and look. If you have to loosen that set screw to get that antenna, do that. This one does not have a set screw. So that is why the blue Loctite is very important. Make sure that you put a little drop on there, not red, just blue. If you own a Harley Davidson, blue Loctite's your best friend anyway. You guys know that. So add the little blue Loctite to the antenna base, screw it on, make sure you put the rag on there, tighten it down. It's that simple, and you've got a cool antenna that works just as good as the long one. So if you have any questions on this one, you guys know the deal. Comment box down below. Check YouTube every day. I'll get back to you as quick as I can. Like I said, if you want to get your hands on this one or the chrome version, the link will be in the description down below. Click that, takes you straight over to Ciro. While you're over at Ciro, check out the rest of the website, guys. Our road glides loaded with Ciro products, street glides loaded with Ciro products. We absolutely love them. If this is your first time hearing about Ciro products, make sure that you browse around the website, because they got a lot of stuff over there. So like I said, this product, brand new. So go over there and check it out at Ciro3d.com. I'm going to get out of here and get my butt back to work, guys. Until the next video, as always, be safe, keep your knees in the breeze.